Hi all, and welcome to the video. In this one, it's Let's Build a Tune Series 3, number 32. So, some of you will probably have spotted where we are. Yes, we're in the alien playfield area. And once again, there have been one or two upgrades. So, not on this side, except for this. We infused it. So, just to give you a quick A-B comparison, here is the standard pistol. Damage goes 200 to 235, or DPS 95.2 to 154.6. Versus this one, which is 300 to 410 and 142.7 to 195. In other words, yeah, it's a damn sight better. We're still pairing that at the moment with the old pistol we got from God, Sector 7. That seems a long time ago. And that's about it on weapons. However, on implants, you can see there's a lot of stuff locked, and the reason is, yes, I put beaters in. It was remarkably easy on a Solicitus at 217. Yesterday we did Dio, which does give a massive amount of XP actually. It's like 3-4 dailies worth at least. And it's quite an easy one to get done. You're in the way! It's quite an easy one to get done, in fact, so I was quite pleased about that. Now, we have done all of the above, and I thought it was probably time to head back to Arid Rift. Yeah, so we are now sat at 218, which is nice. I've upgraded a couple of other nanos. I've been using the second to best void projector, but I managed to find this on GMI for pretty cheap, actually. And it's the top tier one, and also this Omnipol pacification logic system. It's not massively better than the other one, but, you know, OCD. At this level, we should really be using it. So, yeah, that with the two shields, definitely feeling a bit upgraded. Now, we'd got to the point in Arid where we were at a way in, right at the end of the last episode, I think. It depends how I edit it all. So, yeah, we've literally got to run down into the dungeon inside, which is actually a little harder than a lot of the rest of this. The boss in there can be very problematic. Okay, I've saved just because, and then we're going to run down, enter, and see how we do. Oh, I almost forgot. You've upgraded. Brav. Someone commented, you should get the alpha and beta boxes because you will get the top tier dog. So we now have Ravening M60. So dog meat is as upgraded as he is going to get. In fact, I don't think you get anything better. And he's also buffed with all the things. So I'm going to have a quick rebuff of the shields, etc. The only outside buff really, well, I've got that, I suppose. It's not really an outside buff, but that's going to help, I think. Yeah, charged by the machine, because we did the DB quest. Now, the actual marker for this mission, right down there. To get to it, we need to go down this path, swing round a little bit. As you can see, go over sort of two junctions straight down, and then kind of head that way. There's no other way to get to it. It looks like you can get there from this side. Actually, you can't, which is slightly annoying. So, anyway, that's where we're headed. Pets are on behind. I think that's all the upgrades. I can't think of any other ones. We've gone the wrong way. So, adding the control symbionts has meant we can leave all our sort of defensive gear in while we're kind of running around. I think also probably going to be needing this blind. I should have probably started running that before I headed off. We shall see. Am I going the right way? Kind of. Yeah. Flowers and all that. It's always a bit tricky getting down to this area. There's probably an easier way to do it. Yeah, and I want to finish this because that will give me the beta ear, which will then mean just the beta left sides to get done. So the thigh, well, that's 12 man really. I'm not going to bother with the Nivatra, or however you pronounce it, Canyon Quest. It's just so damn long. Almost no one can be bothered with it, but we do a lot of 12 man in Storm, so it shouldn't be too hard to get a hold of. Right, here we are. Okay, let's double check the pet buffs, make sure they're not reset. So we'll give Twitchy all the trimmings. Formula 22, Omnipol Logic, the best AC buff we've got. I'll do the same with Dogmeat. Now, this Dogmeat hits so hard, he keeps pulling aggro. Let's start with you. Oh, we've picked up some adds, okay. The collectors are usually not too much of a problem. I think the boss in here, though, is... I don't know. He's definitely an unknown. I'm going to have to try and hide from him. I also picked up this, Intensive Aura of Sol. It is a shorter, but very effective route. Twitchy, I'm going to give you... Taunt Box. You don't seem to be holding aggro, but I'm not surprised next to the new Dogmeat. He's rather good. His damage is actually brilliant. And our damage is also that little bit better. So with the beaters and a bit of work on perks and stuff, here's our nano skills now. This is running around with composite Moochums on, which, to be honest, I mean... a lot of tunes do. Nope, another collector. Yeah, it still breaks just the same, but just for the hell of having the better stuff. Plow wounds, eh? Oh yeah, I've got a few extra perks and such. So basically, we need to clear this playfield out, more or less. I mean, that's the long and short of it. So. Yes, don't break microphones. Very bad. And we don't want any ads in here while we're trying to deal with the big bad boss, I think. Order of the day. Yeah, that's all the ones this side. These can actually drop your usual AI stuff. Where we're slightly behind on this quest is we haven't picked up any of the items we're going to need to create the disablers for the final boss at the very end. But I think we're going to be okay with him, I think. Don't know. With the warping and everything else, I'm not sure how he's going to be. Yeah, a byproduct of having a better weapon, of course, is you also pull a bit of aggro on yourself. Despite both pets hitting pretty damn hard now. I need to make some quality 200 trimmers. These are definitely out of date. At the very least, I should have 200s now. Right. Some of you would probably argue I should have had them a long time ago. Anyhow, we will get them done. Now, there's a funny NPC in this place. It's weird. If you talk to him, he leaves. If you just save him but don't talk to him, he fights the boss. It's kind of cool. So these guys really are effectively the trash mobs. Yeah, it's funny with mismatched dual wield, you sort of see big damage, little damage, big damage, little damage. It's quite comical in a way. Why did I not have that there? Ah, yeah, that's still hotkeyed. Let's change that. So that's bar 2. Number slot 1. I'm just going to clear that. There we go. Right, now if we head down here, there's a little box. We have to click on it. There's also still some collectors upstairs, but... Now, some of these mobs that spawn in here, like this guy, can be really rather nasty. Yeah, level 280, they're not mucking about. So he's got the intrusive aura, minus 1500. It's quite nice. Okay, well, he wasn't too bad, but some of the others are absolutely a nightmare. And there's three of these boxes. Once they're all done, the actual boss spawns. He's the one you need to watch out for. He's really rather large, and I can't remember what level, but I think it's 300. Now, I've put into the nanomorph perk line. Get this, peel layers. Your layers have been removed. I don't know if the boss actually has any, but could be a useful extra bit of something to throw in there. I should hotbar it. So that's bar number three. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 7. And we scroll all the way down. 3, 10, 3, 7. And we'll change that to another V. Interesting placement of these. Now, I'm trying to think, do I want to do the... We did the middle box, so I want to do that far end one and then this one last, I think. Well, mate, mind you, we could do that far end one last as well. He's strangely not fighting them. Old Jacob. He usually is. Yeah, much nicer burst. However, pulls aggro. Although Twitch is doing well now, he's kind of holding it. Heal him up a little bit. Yeah, let's not hit old Jacob. And yes, you can actually damage him, and yes, he will try and kill you. You know. Actually, we didn't think to buff ourselves with a fresh AC buff. Can't get the 5k yet. That is locked at 220. I thought the dog pet was as well, but no, it's not. Now, normally you can talk to him, he tells you a bit of a tale, and then buggers off. However, not today. I'm going to leave him and he can help us fight the boss later. That's the plan. Right. Did I move away too quick? Probably. There we go. Level 280 again. So yeah, these are not mobs to be taken lightly. Yeah, he's debuffed my init somewhere. Ow! And this one nukes. We have got the hold helmet though, haven't we? Yes, we do. Okay. Yeah, the plan for weapons, I thought, was to finally finish this off. So I'll need to do the solar pistol upgrade as well, and then combine the two. So we've got that. And then in the offhand, probably the Zan pistol, I'm thinking. Fully upgraded one as well. Depends. I'm going to look at that and the multi-range and whatnot. We did this one. We did the middle one. The casket has gone. Now, I've had all kinds of different situations in here with this boss where I've hidden around walls while I've rooted him and all kinds of stuff. I came and did it on my enforcer to help get the ear, and it was remarkably easy. But I think that was just all the HP and buffs he had running. Right, last casket then. Medic. Which means it will heal itself. Like so. Alright, just launch quite a bit of damage at it. Let's send all the perks in. Oh, you swine! Yeah, our damage is okay, but it's struggling a little bit to keep up with this guy's healing. Init debuff would be good about now, or stun with brawl. Fortunately, stop it! Stop healing yourself! You annoying, damned mob! Come on, come on! Oh, God for that. Yeah, so it wasn't hitting as hard, but it's damned healing was being very problematic there. Not at all pleased with that. Right, reload. Pets ready. We got the snare. Yeah, I'm going to put the snare on both, actually. I don't know if that means twice the chance to land, but yeah. Right. I can see its leg. I'm going to try and stay out of the fight as much as I can, and if not, then go in with all the blockers and hopefully do a bit of blinding. Maybe Jacob will come and join us, I don't know. What level is this guy? 290. So yeah, he's kind of a problem, but if Twitchy holds aggro, why am I... Oh, there we go. The reason you're not healing your pet is you don't have it targeted, you muppet. Okay, this is actually working quite well. He said, famous last words. Okay, let Twitchy deal with it. Yeah, keep that going. Alright, let's drop reconstruction on Twitchy. There we go. Now we can focus on blinds. And maybe a little damage. I think Twitchy's going to keep pulling it off us, though. Which is exactly what we want. Okay, this is going an awful lot better than I thought. But there again, we have kind of geared up quite a bit, haven't we? In fairness, we're not quite as gimp as we were. Ow! I'm ready to pop the bio cocoon here. Yes, I am. If I do need to run away, he has got the snare on him, so that's going to give us a little bit of leeway. Not much. Not much, I grant you. I'm rather pleased with this. Twitchy's holding the aggro, but I think Dogmeat is definitely hitting a bit harder. Nice. Okay. Well, seeing as Jacob didn't join in, I suppose, really, we should let him know he can go. Hello, old Jacob. What are you doing here, apart from spectating? You're supposed to run in there and help me fight. You find anything? I have to check before I leave. Okay, I'll head out. Be careful. And that's it. He vanishes. You never see him again unless you come back here. So, yeah, interesting, but there it is. Okay, so the mission is now return to Professor Parser. All the way back there. Well, save the running. That's why we saved, so we can use the insurance claim recall beacon. Oh yeah, that's a bit quicker than running. There's Parser. Let's try not to give him rude answers, although I don't think it actually affects the quest in any way, but... There we go. 5k in AI. Not bad. Not bad. Bit of shadow knowledge too. So what are you saying I should do? I guess asking nicely, blah blah blah. Goodbye. So, now what do we do? Prove the connection. You're starting to get frustrated, wouldn't listen. Alright, so we've got to kill some bosses. First one being the collectors. We should be okay with this, I think, now. With all the goodies we've got running. They're just along the same sort of route you take when you do the find ammunition daily. I'm sure the pets are on follow. Just checking. Now, you can do a bit of avoiding here, I think. Some of the mobs, at least. He says, failing. Right, okay. There's someone here possibly farming. Don't know. Looks like it, because there ain't many mobs here. Hey, are you doing the quest, or are you farming for this guy who's not really moving? Yeah, I think they're farming. Should be better enough. Now, I'm pretty sure it's only the leader we need to kill. Don't know. And he kind of spawns somewhere in there, usually. Oh! Apparently, only needed him. I think. Two of three. I've got items. Right, so the next one doesn't seem to have moved. It's starting to get frustrating. Wouldn't listen to the recent discovery. He claims alien collectors are transporting artifacts from the ancient ruins and wants you to investigate. Blah, blah, blah. Do I need to kill more collectors? Okay. That's going to be difficult if this guy's farming them. Yeah, he's just going to ODs on everything. Or is he on? Is he running the character on a script? Hope not. Because I can't talk to him if that's the case. Hey, hi. I'm doing the quest. Need 3 collector kills. No response at all so far. Well, seems to be ignoring me, so okay. Not sure if he's a farmer. Yeah, he's a farmer. Yeah, he's shooting at it. Well, he's not talking anyway. Okay, so I've got 1, 2, 3. 3 of 3. I need one more. I'm sure you used to have to kill the boss. I only need 3 kills. If you're going to be here for 6 hours, AFK on a script, you know, it's no biggie, is it? Or maybe he just doesn't speak English, I don't know. Could be. Never assume that people do. Right, return with proof. Okay, so lazy, I'm not even going to run. Yeah, I don't know if this one was just out of range or not. Did that fail to film? I seem to remember... yeah, I thought it was harder than that, but okay. Let's use that. It's only a 4-minute cooldown on that one, which I really like. 4 minutes is a lot less than 10, apparently. It certainly feels that way. Right, Dr. Barser. In your own time. There we go. Kill him near the tree. I got hold of the items they possessed, which look like the old tier 3 Shadowland armor stuff, which is garbage, basically. Although, the only set I use now is on my shade, and that's just tier 1 as social armor, because shade armor's cool. Everybody else is, you know, kind of mixed. You know it. What do you want now? More bosses. Right. Okay, the final clue. Yeah. The leaders. That's why I was thinking of that. Right, okay. So we don't need to kill the boss straight away. We got some XP there, so... yeah, I think so. So the one we want, that one, I think, is in amongst all the Zig-type mobs. In a little while since I've done this, and I sort of get it done and then don't think about it again, simply because it's so damn annoying. Usually there's a lot of farmers in here too. Now, do I need to kill them or tag them? Let's try blitzing it. There's a guy. Did I get an update? No. Let's try right-clicking from inventory. Yeah, that did. Okay, bye. We go in. Yeah, it's the last one you actually need to fight. Well, hopefully we're quick enough that the mobs will reset behind us. Should do. There's the guy. Okay, let's right-click him from here. Yep, he did. Final clue, 3 of 4. Assembler leader. Now, we're going to spend a little bit of time with the assemblers, I think, simply because we need stuff that they drop. Actually, no. We want to go this way, really. Usually there's someone at the collectors farming AXP there as well, because they're the softest mobs, I think. I don't know of any that are softer. I mean, maybe. Do-do-do, yeah. Go around a little. Blind all the things. Where's my where's my mission marker gone? Do I even have one? Yeah, I do. This way. What does it actually say? Assembler leader. I now see the marker. Down this little bit. Or is he in... I think he's... no, he's not, is it? This is... yeah. I've done this before, it's confused me. We want to go out and around a bit. It's not where you think it is. That would be dogs. Yeah, there's a little doohickey here. Yeah, like I say, someone up there farming collectors. There you are. Right, right click you. Okay. Well, it's pointless trying to farm when you've got guy there. doing all the killing. And then the last one is the Vickers guy, right down south, near the bottom. Now that one turns into something you have to fight, and it's quite nasty. It's rather big and debuffs you, I think. So obviously, it can be a bit problematic. And if you try and evade it on any high ground, it jumps into can't hit player mode and starts regenerating tons of HP very, very quickly. However, we can do a bit of off ground to avoid some of the adds down here. If I can get up there. Entirely possible I may not and die. So let's hit bio. Get to a bit of higher ground. And yes, let's do a bit of this. Right now, they should have given up. I don't know. Yeah, they did. Okay, so while they're there, let's try and go round them. Get back in here. That's what I was thinking I needed to do. Right, the one guy we need to do is this one. But when we use this on him, you then have to kill him. So just going to wait out that 1 minute for the bio cocoon to come back, because who knows, we may well be needing it. Right, okay, so we're down on there. Going to buff the pets with the snare again. This one doesn't last as long, I don't think. Maybe it does. I'm going to send the pets and then jump down. Now, pets, and kill that, would you? Thank you. Okay, let them build up a bit of aggro. I've been killed by this guy I don't know how many times on different tunes. It's like a train. Not sure if I can blind him even. No, the snare's working, but the blind isn't. Right, halfway should be okay for a bit of our own damage input now. The root won't help a lot because... Ah, it did land. Yeah, the root doesn't help too much, simply because it's quite capable of warping you. Yeah, straight on me there. Which is why I wanted to keep the cocoon running. Nice. Okay, we are not struggling at all. But at 218 with beaters and all the nice toys, really, we shouldn't be. Okay, head on back. I'm pretty sure there's quite a bit more of this to do yet. I seem to remember a lot of running around for parts. It's confusing. Now I really have a lot of things to tell you, ish. Here's your doohickey. And we go. It mutated unexpectedly. So if you're not expecting it, yeah, it can pretty much... You'll think, oh, I've just got to tag it, but it ends up killing you. Listen to the story, because apparently you don't have a choice. It's quite interesting. I mean, if you've never done this quest, all the backstory and stuff isn't bad. It's pretty good. I'd love to hear it voiced, you know, like in, I don't know, Skyrim and the like. Not that I ever want to hear a voiced protagonist in this game. Goodbye. Now then, the aliens. Told you about a woman's been driving him crazy, walking back and forth for hours. Ah, yes. The one I thought we were at earlier on. Blue name, wandering about. There she is. Excuse me, miss. What she said, excuse me, miss. Do I look like a miss? I'd say no, but hey, let's not judge. Right, find Charlie Moss, which we kind of ran to. I think we click him, get a diary spawns in here, and we're done on this one. I think this is pretty simple, but in the interests of not losing lots of XP, yeah. So getting to him, I want to go, not down there, I want to go along through, yeah, down the big long run, which is this way a bit. Oh God. Yeah, that way. Oh dear. I am so bad at navigating. I've come the wrong way, haven't I? I can't get to him this way. No, I can't. Damn it. Derp. Need to go winging it past the collectors yet again. Kind of felt like it was this way, but he's on a different bit. At least we've got the run speed to do this, because at the moment we've got 1962. Like I say, 2k and above in here is a lot better. Simply because you're out of harm's way before you've had a lot of stuff landed on you. So we go down through the gap past all the collector guys, or assembler guys, who drop the parts we will need for the very end. Mind you, if that guy's on a scripted XP thing, we should be all right. Yeah, it's the scientists at the end here. Yeah, if he's just running on script, then we just wait out the timer and loot the bits, you see. But don't want to rain on the guy's day. Right, we're coming up on the scientists now. What's running out there? Yep, gonna have to rebuff that. Why can't that last 4 hours? Right, and the one we want is a lady named Lindsay Wright told you about her friend who's gone missing. They're both volunteers in Arid Rift and supposed to work together. But Wright hasn't been able to contact a friend. You said you would help and suggested you talk to the researchers at the Canyon Camp, one of them being Sherry Tater. Not her. Ah, there she is. You're getting in the way again. I'm looking for someone. His name is Charlie Moss. And we ran past his remains not so long back. Missing friend. So what do we do now? Oh, Dr. Hernandez. I'm looking for someone whose name is Charlie Moss. But now he's missing. And, yeah, quest padding for the win. So now, we're talking to which one? Talk to Lindsay White again. Right, so we talk to her and I'll do what I can. Goodbye. Right, so we now go and use our massive powers of persuasion that we don't have on a unicorn guy who's right round the end. A little breather from the thrum, 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 thrum noise. Gets a bit much after a while, I have to be honest. I don't think there's a quick way around, is there? No. We'll go clockwise, just because clockwise. Right, now apparently he's round here somewhere. The unicorns. That symbol's not quite right. To me, it looks like, if you imagine someone, you know, kind of folding their hand and bending their wrist right round with their thumb tucked in, with an ice cream cone stuck on the end of it. Cannot be unseen. Right, is it this guy we want? The marker's right on him. Let's try this guy. You can pay him money, but we're not doing that because I'm tight. I don't pay for things if I don't have to. And I certainly don't pay too much for them if I don't have to. Hey, that's just survival. 500,000 creds in your sweet dreams. No, going for the next option. Think of the relatives. Think about the publicity. I can see the headlines. Yes, blackmail. Blackmail's better than paying out money. There we go. Right, and go back again. Yeah, this is definitely a bit of quest padding here, and also, you know, to get people out of there. Thankfully, Void Projector isn't flagging us while we're there, because that would be too big a temptation for people that is someone like me running around in there with a big flag. Although, provided we could get away, I think we'd do fairly well with all the blockers. I don't know. a pro PvPer, probably kick our backside. I'm very rusty. PvP for me is CSGO, Overwatch, Armor, HZ3. They're kind of PvP games to me. PvP in AO is kind of bizarre. It's rock, scissor, paper, stone is the best way I can describe it. But yeah, if an agent comes after you, pretty tricky. Thankfully, we have pretty much seen an end to boxing in PvP. Not completely. It does still happen, but it's much rarer than it used to be. Because it was appalling. Lindsay White, right where she wandered off to. She was just here. You gone for a little wander around this way? No. She does wander around a bit, you know. Ah, there she goes. I probably looked right at her. I can see the comments now. Lindsay White was right in front of you. You completely missed her, you noob. You blind old man. Well, yeah, I could do with a bigger monitor, I'm not going to lie. Yeah, it sends you here, but that's where his corpse is, where my mouse is now. I think we just click on it as well. I don't think it gets any more complicated. Just make sure we're saving. Yeah, we are definitely saving some shadow knowledge there. So, sensors, it's down past the shipwreck. So, we're running the same bloody way again. Yeah, I've seen a lot of people go to the marker it gives you and kind of go, don't know. Meanwhile, 50,000 mobs jump on top of you. But actually, Charlie Moss is just around the corner. There we go. And now go back. Okay. I'm very lazily. We're going to use the beacon again. So much better. Right, where is she? Oh, there she is. I couldn't bring him back, but I've got his diary. You can kind of read it, but Charlie is dead. I'm sorry. No, it's I'm sorry, Charlie is dead. Surely. You know, did you give the poor girl a bit of a run-up to the terrible news you're about to give her, surely? Right, we want the top socket and the bottom socket. Top socket there, bottom socket there. So pretty much back where we just came from. Keep getting XP, not gonna complain. Now when we get them, who do I give it to? Dig them up, but I'm not sure we give them to her even. I've done this before where I've run down here, grabbed the top half and thought I've done it. And no, you haven't. There is more to actually get hold of. Why is it in a fight at all? Follow, 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 follow. Now let's try and do this without stopping. So back in the little bit we found Charlie Moss inside, there should be a glowing thing at the end. Indeed, there is. Got it, right. Top half. But you see, it gives you this, and you're not done yet. No, you're not, you see. You need to come around and get the second half. That's what trips people up, I think, is that the mission pointer changes. The bottom half is somewhere around here, I think. Am I being blind? I know this has tripped me up so many times trying to find the second piece. Ah! Yes, you're bloody blind! Right, now take it to Dr. Hernandez, who is just at the end here. That helps. I think if it lands, at least it will help. It will snare all the nasties. But they've carried on following. Hernandez, I think she'd say. Yeah, contact Dr. Hernandez. Take his hand and introduce yourself. He's not a little old lady. Right, okay, so we're giving him this bit, and one of those. Says lots of words. Yes, thank heaven I didn't try and use it. Yes, I'll do what I can. Right, so now we've got to run round and cage lots of these mobs. They're kind of dotted around pretty well. They're not along here though. You tend to find a lot more of them next to the plants, I seem to remember. Okay, there's one. assembler. We're going to need to kill a lot of these, I think. Oh, that was one. I think. Yeah, so that's two of them. Right, like I say, we're in the plant area now, I think. Yeah, pretty much. Sure, I usually see some around here, but, you know, not always. What are you? Yes, you'll do. Oh, look, they're queuing up. And you. Any more this way? We have to come back here later and play with plants. Oh, God. Keyboard fail. There we go, and one more. Oop, snared myself. Return to Hernandez. Hoorah! That worked quite well. That I'm not sure what he's about. I never have been. There's a guy running around in here that doesn't seem to have anything associated. I'm sure there's some sort of quest he's attached to, but for the life of me, I don't know what that is. I forgot to renew this. Thankfully, it is still running. So I think when we get back and talk to Hernandez, I'll take that opportunity to rebuff a little bit. We could have saved a bit of time farming. Assemblers seem to have the best drop rate. Fortunately, they're also quite an easy kill, which is why you get so many people farming them. Right, okay. Hernandez. I'm not trying to attack him. Yet. Did I just click the wrong things? Try again. There we go. I managed to extract the data from 10 of the aliens. All right. Goodbye. Oh, got some research as well. What have I just finished and what do I want to be on? We've just done that. Multi-ranged, burst, and then pistol. Yeah, well, we'll stay with that one. Can't do any more in apotheosis till we get a couple more AI levels. So I'm now talking to this guy. Yeah, he's about as friendly as an unfriendly thing. Blah, blah, blah. He asks you to go and talk to his alien girlfriend. However, turns out not that friendly. And it's another trek back out down again. Ho-hum, here we go. Or are we doing plants? I think we're doing plants. Where's the tool? No, it's pick up and use. Okay, and next plant. I thought it was talk to his alien girlfriend. That must be later then. Makes you run around like a blue bottle. Running with the item in front of you. Makes it slightly easier, except that that happens. Not interested in being rooted. Leave me alone. Now we want this plant. If everyone could just get out of my way. Trying to work here. Let's just and then have you got the root twitch? Oh wait, I'm gonna give it to you. Behind and follow. See ya. See how you like being rooted. Okay, we did that one. Sending me a different way. I can see the map marker on the playfield map as well as the mini map. There it is, I think. Thought we did this one, but hey. I like snaring these things back. Kind of feels like justice. And back to the scientists. What I've never understood is why we have to have rum running constantly while you're in here. Like, it isn't annoying enough in here. No, we're going to give it a sound that's a bit like toothache and a migraine combined on the ears. It's always the same. When I start this, I go, oh yeah, it's kind of sunny. Let's do this now. While the sun is shining, it will look so much better. And then it does this, and it's all murky and horrible. Yeah, there's your plant feeder. Anything else you can tell me? Ah, here we go. Now we meet his girlfriend. Unfortunately, we're going to go back there and kill it. Because that's just how we roll. Now, the mob we want's over in the side there. Typically, you get a lot of mobs following you, but you need to find a way to get them to go away. Usually this broken bit of geometry here. Yeah, that normally does it. Like so. Right, alien envoy. It's his girlfriend. That's what it is. It is. We try and talk. What was I supposed to say? What are you doing here? Are you here because of the Zan? Doesn't look amused now. And, yeah. And then it decides it's going to fight you. Ah, that would be lag. It's 1330 hours. Time for lag. Oh, this one came back. Nice of you to join us. Not. Okay, go back to parser. Yeah, go and kill it. Let's have the XP. Oh, we got another one. Oh, no, no, it's got another friend. Not too worried about those. You can kill those for a repeatable mission. Does hand out quite a bit of research, that mission. You know, just while we're here, we're trying to get into the spirit of things. Plus, they might actually drop some parts we need. I don't think that one dropped anything, though. You can see there, they do give a bit of research, but they also give a fair old bit of alien XP. And we've earned that from pretty much zero when we started, because we just hit another AI level. Right, behind follow. Let me check in for loot. Nothing. Right, so we're back to the doctor to say, well, kind of sorry, but we killed your girlfriend. Yeah, pets on guard, standing AFK. The way of the warrior. It is effective, though. You can go to bed in an area, you'll either come back to the PC and your character's either sat wherever it was they last saved because they died, or you've earned a fair bit of alien XP while you've not been there. Right, okay. Yes, about your girlfriend, Stockton. Kind of sorry about that. What's this one? Yeah, he doesn't want to talk to you anymore. Talk to Hernandez again. Yeah, he's a nutcase. He had an alien girlfriend. Why can't I tell him this? It's all there. Right, okay. And now, talk to Sherry Data. My Sherry. Hello again. We said hello to her like 10 minutes ago. Well, it might have been longer than that, actually, but hey. Yeah, this is the very end now. Right, so we need a green bit, a red bit, etc., and some other bits. So I'm going to farm those, and that could take any amount of time because, well, there's a bunch of people in that area. So it's going to take as long as it takes. But we need a red bit, a green bit. It's like traffic lights, I think. Totally not being obstructive in any way. Standing on loot. Oh, God. I don't think they're even there. Look, they're completely ignoring one of these. Because it's not aggroing them. No, no, no. We need the coloured lights. Yes, we do. Is it just the leader in here? No, he'll do. So you're not competing with this one because this one isn't attacking them. Yeah, they're just on AFK. Which is great. It means we can't talk to them. And there's like two different teams there as far as I can see. No, not a part we need. Do you want that, though? Okay. And a green. Nice. Oh, no, I've done green. Done green. Don't need green. I need a red one there. Need a red one. Unattended gameplay is against the rules. Yeah, how'd you prove it? Oh, I fell asleep while I was playing. It's not. I wouldn't ban someone for that. Green again. No, we want a red one. There's probably a red one underneath these guys. He's not AFK. He's trying to loot. Oh, he's running on a script. Hey, red one. That's all I wanted, guys. See ya. Right, we've got the part. Return to Tater 3 times. So I'm going to hand these in and then rebuff before I go on to the next bit. I managed to build the 3 jammers. A lot of words. And then we need to use them on the towers and then just kill the boss. And we should get a detonation thing. I'll do what I can to destroy it. Because actually that's the truth. Right, I'm going to rebuff. Right, probably confused the hell out of the pets. Oh no, we got one. We got two. Behind and follow. Okay, let's try and get this right. So, we have an alien barrage tower. Spot jammer, barrage jammer. Now, is it right click from inventory? That's doing something. Okay, and we've got a sweep tower. We've got a sweep jammer. A right clicking from inventory, I seem to remember being the way. And then finally, a spot tower. Okay. Then we want this guy for quite a long time. Now we don't have to completely kill him. We click this. Orbital strike. Only this one doesn't actually kill you like the one does for the regular alien daily. Oh, here's the other trick. He warps you directly underneath him. This is a laser-tagging device tuned to a special location by the Unicorn Company. The health of the target needs between 25% and 50%. So you've only actually got to take him halfway down. Which is slightly better than having to do the entire thing. It still takes a while, however. Except it didn't on in the NT. Do that, and then I'm going to pop Reconstruction on Twitchy. To make him even more aggressive. Right, I think that is just below. Yeah, that's doing something. Run away! I don't think it makes any difference. Go on. No? Oh, I had to be under it, did I? Yeah, we took a bit of damage there. But not to worry. Right, where do we go from here? We have to go back to those scientist guys. With crappy frame rate until all the debris clears. Yeah, there you go. Now it's all right again. The rest of the engine optimization in here is perfectly fine though, so what can I tell you? Go away, scout ship. No one asked. Nobody was asking you. Run, follow me into the gate of death. No? Oh, never mind. Right, so back to Sherry. Could you see the orbital strike from over here? Probably not with these bloody great walls. I found this strange object. Did I? Apparently I did. Are you okay? I'm fine, I think. No, we've got interpretation program running for an hour. Right, we're out of here. Almost done. Right, okay. So let's walk back to the start and talk to Lab, who will warp us to the little room above him. It's the only time you can actually enter that room, as far as I know. I'm not aware of another way of doing it. Just going to kill the blind, just in case. Right. Unicorn Commander Lab. Sorry to bother you. I think I'm giving him this. A hostile alien nano program. There we go. Doesn't seem to be causing too many problems. And there's a lot of words, but basically he says, send him up there. The unmistakable of time and space bending. Yay! We're in the funny little room above him. See there? We're not showing on the map, and you can't jump to character. It just doesn't know where you are. It's a separate instance, but it does feel like you're looking out on Arid Rift from that little room, but... Right. And you got, you know, big tank of goo, and then apparently it's the it's that guy's girlfriend. She's in a jar. It's not a good look. There we go. Who are you? Basically, the story this tells you is that the aliens and all of the unredeemed and redeemed mobs, why are you in the tank? And we didn't hit you that hard. Yeah. Are actually one original species, and so are the human race, that were kind of split into different ones, and the Zan is where it all starts to come back together or something. And then they stopped writing the story. There's a bit more lore to it than that, but I'd rather you found that out for yourselves. Yeah, and it throws this big guilt trip on you, but hey, you ready to go? Yes, because I've been in there before, but yeah, have a look around if you ever go. So that's it, the alien threat. It tells you to go to, well, we zoom out and then click mission again. Yeah. Mitar Hero. Another good place for farming. So there we go. We've got the artillery. If I click it, oops, it'll jump into overflow. And now it's the control one. So that will be going in before the next episode. But I think we're going to leave it there for now. Okay, folks. Bye for now.